Welcome to Decima Architecture. My name is Andrea, and I'm here with Florian from GumGum. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So what do you guys do?
Yeah, so GumGum is a technology company that is on a mission to erase the use of personal data in digital advertising. And to do so, we power Verity, our very own contextual intelligence platform that provides the ability for our clients to classify text, web pages, images, video, and audio content.
Great. This is on AWS, so let's dive in.
Sure.
And find out what it does.
Sure. So most of the work happens in the region here. So here our clients will go and talk to our API and say, for example, I want to classify gumgum.com web page and know what's in that web page.
Okay.
So the first flow is users interact with API gateway that will then communicate with our EKS cluster on which we run our main API, RESTful API product. And this API will do a database lookup on Dynamodb to see if we have any information about gumgum.com.
I see. And if that information isn't there, how do you do the contextual analysis?
Yeah. So as part of the EKS cluster, we have another component that acts as an orchestrator.
Okay.
And this orchestrator will also initiate a classification request back to our entire GumGum AI. So the GumGum AI stack here is made of natural language processing microservices, as well as computer vision microservices.
Wonderful. So you run your custom models to do the contextual. And then do you store that information back in Dynamodb?
Yeah. So there's a whole back and forth here in between ECS microservices and EKS.
Okay.
And the component here will keep updating Dynamodb until we get the classification fully complete and return it back to the client.
Awesome. I'm super curious with Outpost. Right, and talk us through, what was the requirement that led you to pick Outpost for this use case?
Yeah, so as you guys know, I mean, the AI is a process that is sometimes slow, right?
Mm-hmm.
And achieving like a high throughput and really low latency on AI inference is quite challenging. The system here wasn't built with latency in mind, but just, you know, serve different type of use cases, Verity, you know, classifies video and a whole set of different things, but certain clients here have just the need to classify web pages. So the Outpost here, and for this specific client, we needed to achieve a latency of less than 10 milliseconds, and that was our SLA. And this is doing 100K requests per second.
Wow.
So this is really intensive.
Okay, so walk us through the flow, right? So I see users, clients, say, I need that sub 10 millisecond, that's low latency. What happens?
Yeah. So the interesting part here is that we've been redesigning our API product that runs here, and we rewrote it in Go so that we build it with direct latency in mind. So we have this API product here running on EKS, so we can call it our Edge API. And this Edge API here running on EKS will simply do lookups in Elasticache.
I see. Okay, for retrieval of information.
Yeah.
So you essentially have your cluster API request coming in here. Now, talk us through the rationale. Now, what size is this?
Yep.
And what's your cache hit ratio?
Yep. So part of the design of this whole outpost was to really consider how do we want to leverage those EC2 machines and to do what and how many of them we needed.
Okay.
So what we plan here is that the Elasticache cluster is 1 terabyte big. So we dedicate a bunch of nodes to run, you know, the Redis cluster. But here, as you can see, there might be a challenge here where we have 15 terabytes of classification data in DynamoDB. And basically, not all the data here fits in the cluster.
And you know, if we can talk about eviction process, you know, what's your cache hit ratio and what's the eviction process? How often do you, you know, store new information on it?
Yeah, so new information is being stored like just in real time. Like we keep adding new data because this client keeps asking for new pages, and you know, the web is dynamic by nature, and so we keep getting new information. What matters for this client is to get as much contextual information as possible.
Mm.
So the least frequently used page is not really useful to be stored in this cache, given that we have only 1 terabyte. So we use a least recently used eviction policy, which means that our Elasticache cluster is always full and always evicting data to
I
store
see.
New contextual data
okay.
coming.
And assume that you have not seen that web page before. So mm-hmm. there's no contextual information here. What do you do?
Correct. So to close the gap on the other side, so here we have a replication process in between this region that will sync up the data from Dynamo to Redis. But now on the other side, this component here, the Edge API, is also aware of where do I go if I need to initiate a new classification? And this message will be sent back to the main region to another component here that we run on our EKS so that we can just resume the first loop that we went through.
So you have an orchestration, you know, essentially kicking off that mm-hmm. whole AI ML analytics
yes.
and then bringing back onto Elasticache.
Yes, that is correct.
Awesome, Florian. Thank you so much for walking us through this contextual platform that you built for low latency requirements, and we truly have appreciated this overview.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching. This is My Architecture.